Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about AC bridges. So in this we will discuss resistance capacitance bridges, that is RC bridges, which is used for capacitance measurement. The parallel resistance capacitance bridge circuit is the most appropriate bridge when capacitances with low dielectric resistance are to be measured. Such capacitances have high dissipation factor and reasonably high leakage current. In this bridge circuit, the unknown capacitor is represented by a parallel combination of pure capacitance Cx and resistance Rsh. The circuit for parallel resistance capacitance bridge is shown in the figure. The standard capacitance C1 is also connected in parallel with variable resistance R1. The resistances R3 and R4 are configured in the same way they were configured in the case of a series resistance capacitance bridge. These resistances are adjusted alternatively along with R1 to balance the bridge. We know that at balance the following condition is satisfied, and the condition is Z1 Z4 equals to Zx into Z3. So this is the condition for balance of the bridge. In complex notations, these impedances written as (1/Z1) equals to (1/R1) minus (1/J/ωC1). Or 1/Z1 is 1/R1 plus J omega C1. Z1 equals to 1/R1 plus J omega C1. Similarly, Zx is written as 1/Rsh plus J omega Cx, and Z3 and Z4 are purely resistive, so we can write Z3 is equal to the R3 and Z4 is equal to the R4. Substituting these equations in the balance equation, so balance equation we already know, that is Z1 Z4 equals to Zx Z3. So if you substitute the values for this equation, then we will get (R4/1/R1) plus J omega C1 equals to (R3/1/Rsh plus J omega Cx). Or we can write R3 in bracket (1/R1) plus J omega C1 equal to the R4 in bracket (1/Rsh plus j omega cx. If we equate and separate the real and imaginary terms, then we will get RSH equals to R1 into R4 upon R3, and for CX, C1 R3 upon R4. So from these equations, it is clear that the result is exactly the same using series resistance or parallel resistance capacitance bridges. The capacitances with moderate leakage resistance should be measured by a parallel resistance capacitance bridge, since it provides a direct deflection of leakage resistance capacitance. We will see one numerical. A parallel resistance capacitance bridge possesses C1 equals to 0.2 microfarad and R3 is equal to the 12 kilo ohm. C1 0.2 microfarad and R3 12 kilo ohm. The bridge achieves balance when F is 150 Hertz R1 is 345 kilo ohm and R4 is 15 kilo ohm. So we have to determine the first is resistive and capacitive components, and second is dissipation factor. So here the unknown capacitance Cx can be measured by C1 R3 upon R4. So we know the values. C1 is 0.2 microfarad, therefore 0.2 into 10 raised to minus 6 is written, and for R3 it is 12 kilo ohm, so 12 into 10 raised to 3, and R4 is 15 kilo ohm, so 15 into 10 raised to 3 is written. And after solving this equation, we will get Cx as 0.16 microfarad. The unknown resistance RSH can be found as R1 R4 upon R3. Now substituting the values of R1, that is 345 into 10 raised to 3, 345 kilo ohm, and R4 is 15 kilo ohm, 15 into 10 raised to 3, upon R3 is 12 kilo ohm, so 12 into 10 raised to 3, and after calculating we will get RSH equals to 431.25 kilo ohm. So these are the resistive and capacitive components, that is Cx and RSH. Now the dissipation factor D of a capacitor can be determined as 1 upon omega Cx RSH, and omega is nothing but the 2 pi f cx r sh. So here again substituting the values, f frequency is 150 hertz, cx is 0.16 microfarad we have calculated, and rsh that is also calculated, that is 431.25 kilo ohm. So we are getting the value of dissipation factor d as a 0.0154. So this is the value of dissipation factor of the capacitor. Now we will see next bridge, shearing bridge circuit. The shearing bridge circuit is basically a modification of series resistance capacitance bridge or series RC bridge. The circuit of a shearing bridge is shown in the figure. The unknown leaky capacitance, that is a series combination of Cx and Rs, is compared with the standard capacitance C1. The standard capacitance is usually a pure capacitance with mica or air as dielectric, which provides an extremely high dielectric resistance. The parallel combination of C3 and R3 is meant to adjust the phase angle of current IA flowing through the impedances Z1 and Z3. This ensures balance in the voltage drop between Z1 and Zx, thereby balancing the bridge. The combination of C3 and R3 eradicates the need of a resistance in the C1 arm. Small capacitance values at low AC voltages can be measured precisely using a shearing bridge. In addition, the dielectric and insulation properties of capacitances at high voltages can be accurately analyzed with this bridge. The balance equations of the bridge can be derived in the usual manner. The complex notation of the impedances can be written as Z1 equals to minus J upon omega C1, Zx equals to, if Z1 is here, so for Zx, Rs minus J upon omega Cx. For Z3, 1 upon R3 plus J omega C3, and Z4 is equal to the R4. So we know that the balance equation, balance condition is z1 z4 equals to zx into z3. So we'll substitute these complex values in this balance equation, then we'll get minus j upon omega c1 into r4 equals to rs minus j upon omega cx into 1 upon r3 plus j omega c3. Then rs minus j upon omega cx minus j upon omega cx equals to r4 in bracket minus j upon omega c1 into in bracket 1 upon r3 plus j omega c3. And then next is rs minus j upon omega cx equals to minus j r4 upon omega c1 r3 plus r4 c3 upon c1. Now equating real and imaginary parts, we get the RS equals to R4 C3 upon RC1 and CX equals to C1 R3 upon R4. And these equations it is clear that the unknown capacitance in shearing bridge is obtained by the same relation as that of previous RC bridges, while the resistance is calculated in terms of capacitance. Now we can easily express the dissipation factor of shearing bridge shown in the figure or shearing bridge circuit, and that is D equals to omega C3 R3. This is the expression for dissipation factor. If resistance R3 of the circuit is fixed value resistance, then the dissipation power factor becomes proportional to the capacitance C3. This enables the calibration of capacitance dial such that the dissipation factor of the unknown capacitance can be directly read on it. The term omega in this relation indicates that the dial calibration is applicable only for the frequency at which it has been calibrated. Some corrections have to be made at all other frequencies. For this, the ratio of the two frequencies must be multiplied by the dial reading. When measurements are to be done at high voltages, a step-up transformer operating at power frequency is used to provide the supply voltage to the bridge. Also, variable capacitance C1 is replaced by the fixed with a guard ring. This is to isolate the leakage currents at such high voltages. Ground screens are also used to eradicate the stray capacitance effect. Only components C3, R3 and R4 are adjusted to attain the balance condition. The voltage drop across impedances Z1, ZX will be relatively more than those of other impedances to ensure the safety of the operator. So we will continue some part of this shearing bridge and numerical as well as Venn bridge we will see in next video. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दी वीडियो।